What up, dude? This is a sick SBK here coming at you with the third game in a row. I know, I'm casting three games in a row while sick. Ugh, god, ow. Ah! Alright, hate being sick. Sucks. Wait, hang on, give me a minute. Alright, I'm back. Oh, god. Had to blow my nose. Bunch of blood mixing the mucus. Yeah, gross. Anyway! God, game three between Zelsing and Lollet, and we're gonna see Lolliet. I call him Lollet just to be easier. All right, Night Elf versus Orc. Thank God this is Night Elf versus Orc game. I thought I picked the Orc versus Orc mirror in game one. I was like, oh crap. But yeah, very standard build from both, and we're gonna see the barracks. Is Orc gonna skip the second burrow? I don't know. He didn't do it last game. Last game was a bigger map, so I don't see any reason for him to skip this game. Yeah, getting the Playmaster a little late here, buddy. Anyway, we're gonna see the Playmaster versus the Demon Hunter again. If there was ever a Valentine in Warcraft, I think these two heroes would have gotten it. Playmaster and Demon Hunter has faced off against each other more often than, say, Archmage and Warden. Well, maybe they make a bigger, better couple because one of them is actually a chick. But tell me what do you think? What two Warcraft units can make a best Valentine? Unit or hero, doesn't matter. Can say Dark Ranger and DK, or Naga Sea Witch and the Blood Mage. I don't know. Be creative. You don't have to stick with the units. You can say, I don't know, Banshees and Necromancers, or Banshees and Priests. Leave your comments. I'm gonna read them, see what you guys can come up with. Anyway, Demon Hunter is gonna be out. Let's see, two Wisps and then Watcher. So lightning, give me lightning. There we are. Thundercast. Okay, never mind. Back to Warcraft. Hey. Very standard creeping. Let's see if the Blame Arts can go. Oh no, he's not gonna go hit and run. Not hit and run, like item and run. He's gonna go actually finish off his camp. Two Wisps are positioned right here and here, so pretty interesting. Let's see the Night of Vision, so you can see. Okay, this Wisp is gonna see this creeping going on. This Wisp, I can see absolutely nothing. And that looks like Lollet is gonna go. Almost lost his Asian War there. And what happened to his two Wisps? Oh, they're over here. And he's gonna get a ring protection plus three. Meanwhile, our Orc player is going to get a circular ability. That saves him some money from buying it from the shop. Anyway, we're going to see the Demon Hunter is going to go after this green camp here, and he should have a 2.5 Demon Hunter after this camp. And Orc is going to get a level 2 Blade Master after this camp. Very standard from both, very not monotonous, but standard slash boring. From this length of replay, I'm gonna expect something spectacular later on, because look at this replay. 4 minutes, 3.5 minutes, saying we're not even close to 1/10. So this is gonna be an epic game here. Two moonwalls being built. I think the shop is gonna be built right after this moonwall here. I think this Wisp is gonna build it actually. We're gonna see the Demon Hunter is gonna try. What? He's gonna creep this camp? This is one of those camps is so annoying because there's so much damage output. And it's so annoying to creep because they have so much HP, and they have ensnare and poisoned. It's an ideal camp for a Dark Ranger, that's for sure, because you can just turn all of them into skeletons. But as a Demon Hunter using, I really don't know. Demon Hunter did grab the item though, as a circling ability. He did sell the ring protection and grab a circling ability from a shop. Here we go. Oh, Bannerburn almost got him. Demon Hunter is gonna use the dust on the. Oh god, level 2 mana burn already, so the Blade Master is gonna have to, bring your boys when you try to game ban this Blade Master. Yep, game ban this Demon Hunter instead of solo him, because the level 3 Demon Hunter already, holy crap, with two circle abilities, it's pretty hard to kill. Anyway, this camp is cleared. Where is the Asian War went, so we can see where is he gonna go after this third time. Nope, Asian War is gonna go walk home. I think he's gonna block here. Yep, and here comes the shop. Tier 2 almost done by both players. What is Demon Hunter doing? What is he gonna try to burn mana burn him to zero? Yep, And he's gonna get out of there. I'm like, haha, you had no mana. Haha. And in the meantime, Orcus are gonna just try to creep this middle shop here, and Demon Hunter won't leave him alone. Look at this. This is kinda funny, actually. Demon Hunter will be like, haha, you're not. You think you're creeping that camp, but you're not. And now Orcus will position all of his, most of his units behind the creeps, so the... Here comes the Beastmaster, though. Demon Hunter is coming right back. Be like, what's up, Blademaster? Now I got backup as well, so let's see who's what. But I still think the Beastmaster should grab the Staff of Preservation right when he spawns, because you can harass a work base. This is not how you're supposed to use the Beastmaster, by the way. Why? Because of this. Because the tier 2 buildings are going up by from orc, in the orc base. You really need to cancel these to buy you some time before orc timing is going to kick in. It's about 1 minute timing the orc needs to hit to take map control, creep, or just where's the Blademaster going? Blademaster is going to come over and say hi to the Beastmaster. And the Demon Hunter is going to kill Grunt, a really bad control by the Zork player. No, not bad, but subpar. You know what I mean. You know what I mean. Like a really good pro, like a Grubby, will never lose that Grunt. Well, again, he makes like two or three Grunts versus Nine Elf, so what? A Shadow Hunter? What? What? Normally, when you get Shadow Hunter, you already have a two or three Mercs in your army already. That's when you get Shadow Hunter, because you need to heal the Mercs. But looks like nice kill using the archer. But looks like this orc is gonna get a Shadow Hunter without getting Mercs. And that's interesting, because I really don't understand this. Okay, nice blocking using that Beastmaster. The Blademaster is gonna get out of there. Shadow Hunter is gonna creep the 8 o'clock. He's gonna get a item, and you're gonna get a level 0.85? I don't know. Anyway, hidden expo. I really like the position of this expo, because if you scout here, you're not gonna see it, especially at night. Night Elf will never see it. The Night Elf does not have ultra vision, by the way, without a Hunter's Hall, by the way, so just keep that in mind. Let's see if the Night Elf is gonna scout the expansion. We're gonna put on Night Elf vision. Nato player's vision. That would be sweet if you can put on Nato vision. But now he's going to get distracted by this orc army. He's going to kill Grunt here, yep. And the Grunts cannot run home, because that's going to lead the Nato straight to the expansion. So the Grunts are going to have to stick around. Raiders, oh, here comes the Beastmaster. Is he going to see it? Oh, yes, he sees the expansion. That's out of the way. Blademaster did kill Merc. That's gonna hit the Shadow Hunter and the Blademaster to the next level. Then the Beastmaster gonna go down. Oh no. He can execute a four unit surround with the two Raiders if he wanted to. But looks like the Demon Hunter, bad idea, Demon Hunter, you gotta get out of there! You cannot afford to do this! No! There's a Hex, and Raiders gonna come around and ensnare him. Ensnare, there we go. And the Demon Hunter is out of luck. Demon Hunter pops a potion, that's a vulnerability, but Raiders can chase him around. Yeah, he can surround him or chase him. And the Demon Hunter has got the TP here. I don't know if he can get lucky on the critical strike. There we go. Demon Hunter is going to TP. He didn't cancel the expansion. Lost a Beastmaster. I really don't know what this Nato is doing. Tinker is out, by the way, so... Didn't cancel tier 2 buildings. Did kill two Grunts, by the way. I should give him credit for that, but that's it. Now the orc is going to roam around the map. Let's see what the orc has planned, because last game he tried to expand and got denied time and time again. Last game was a bigger map as well, so I really don't know what would have happened, but let's see what he just has in mind. He kind of showed us last game where he went tier 3 Tauren with level 2 upgraded Spirit Walkers, where you can revive all your units if you do it right. Because Spirit Walker can revive fallen Spirit Walkers and Taurens, so there you go. I really like this Night Elf does not have the DOS on auto cast, Fairy Fire, because it drains your energy. It drains all your DOS, your out of their energy. Mana, duh, energy. So, yeah, I really like that. I'll already have Cyclone, and let's see if he's going to go back to that expansion. Great win, I think before we go there, I think he wants a level 2 Beastmaster, I'm pretty sure, but Orca already cleared the 4 o'clock. That's a lot of raiders, holy crap. Uh-oh. Don't get Cyclone. There we go. No! Oh god, run! Run as fast as you can! Pop the speed score! No, you don't need to, but you know what I mean. Hashama Hunter about to be level 3. What is this Blademaster doing with the Fairy Fire? Of course, now I was fully aware of this Blademaster, the existence of Blademaster. I need to switch back to my vision. Here we go. Nadov knows where the Blademaster is, so there's no surprise when the Blademaster starts chopping down your wisps. More Raiders are gonna come out. Is he gonna go Raiders, all Raiders, the entire game? Is he gonna go base trade? What? Okay, that does give you a advantage when you go for base trade like this, but your Raiders aren't gonna get picked off like that. Unless you're not gonna bother with the Nadov army because they have so little DPS as far as units concerned. The heroes are has more than half of the DPS in the Nadov army, in case you don't know, because the Demon Hunter was about 1/3 of the army, and the summons from the Beastmaster and the Tinker are going to make up the other 1/3. And the DOS just do magical damage against Raiders, which is next to nothing. And the Blademaster is going to come over. He's going to buy something? What did he buy? He didn't buy anything. Didn't like the collection the marketplace has. And now I'm curious, what is he getting the expansion for? He's still at below 50 food. Banking on money. Blademaster is going to go... Oh, is he going to go base trading the entire time? Oh! Because Nadov cannot afford to leave the base. Because if you do... If you're gonna go pressure the expansion, this is what happens. Oh god, and the Fairy Fire is gonna reveal these raiders. Nadov saw they're coming mile away, but they can... I really don't understand this. So the peons are gonna try to repair. Here comes the Blademaster. Sorry, Blademaster is still around. Just to check there, 4 o'clock. But the raiders are going to kill all these Moonwells. Oh my god. Do they even have level 1 weapons upgrades? The Swarm Mail is on the way, so the level 1 weapons upgrade should be on the way as well. Beastmaster needs to have a TP so he can come right back to the base to save his entire main. Otherwise, the entire main is gone. It lost every single Moonwell. The Night Elf has 10 food at maximum. I don't have to approve all these additional wins to do this. Demon Hunter can be killed, by the way. If the Demon Hunter is not careful, he can be killed. That's when the Beastmaster needs to run to the shop. Oh, never mind. There's a shop TP on the Tinker. So now what do you do? You killed 5 peons and an expansion. Whoopity fucking do. Now what? Now you lost everything, you know, man. Everything. By that I mean nothing but two lumber wisps. Oh my god. 4 Moonwells, one additional wind, one altar, one shop. Oh my god. And additional war, I think. Oh man. Now that I was gonna have to go all in. Let's see Orca can't defend this. That was well worth it. I might want to start doing that now. Oh my god. I was wondering, why didn't he get any mercs? Because if you're gonna go Shadowhunter, you might as well go mercs. Wow. Raiders are gonna go for another run. Now he needs to go back to base and defend. brilliant play. I really learned a lot. I quote the great baseball player slash commentator. He said something that I thought is really applicable to all sports, also including esports. He said, oh crap, that Raider's gonna die. He said, it's amazing. He played baseball for like, what, 10 years or something, and he commentated the game for like 20. I think he's in Baseball Hall of Fame. He said, it's amazing that we don't know about a game that we've been playing for in our entire lives. This is one of those instances where I learned something new about a 10-year-old game. Anyway, it looks like the Blademaster is going to go in for another harassment, and he is going to get repelled. I really love to see what he typed. I think he's Korean, but I'd really love to see what he typed to the other guy. Now what do you do? You're going to have to rebuild altars, shops, and moonwalls. And there's a fourth moonwall right there, tucked in right there, just to getting away from the raiders. Holy crap. Those raiders are effing scary, dude. Now where are the raiders going? That's a lot of raiders. Nothing but raiders. No grunts. No mercs. One spare walker just to dispel the fair fire. Yeah, that's it. That's the entire army. Nothing but raiders. Mass raiders is going to win this. So the Night Elves got to buy TP here. Yep, he did buy TP on the Beastmaster, but here we go. He's going to have to use that TP right now. I'm pretty curious as to, yeah, there's a pillage. Yeah, I saw pillage on the orc. See the orc, the orc resources is going up, not by 10, but by increments of not 10. So that's when you know the orcs have pillage. So now orcs are going to contribute straight TP, coming here, do some siege damage against Night Elf buildings, and then just trade TPs. And with the pillage, you're going to end up you're going to end up with the better hand either regardless, because you have pillage, you have siege damage, you force them to repair. The TP trade is even. Wow. So now the raiders are going to I've never seen raiders being used like that. And also buys time for your expansion. Let's see if he can get out of this one. You cannot do this. One of the things you cannot do is to beat the Night Elf army in the middle of a map. That's when you get screwed. Let's see. Shadowhunter. Go to the shop. No! Beastmaster grabbed the TP and a potion of lesser availability already, but that was a while ago. Let's see if the Shadowhunter grabs it. Got a TP! No! TP! No! Orc had plenty of money. Why didn't he get it? The Night Elf didn't buy it, I don't think. No, the Night Elf didn't. Why didn't he get a TP? Is there a lag? Oh, it is Zotac. It is Zotac cuff, so there might be a little lag in there. That could be the only reason. That might be the only reason that he didn't get a TP right there. So now the Night Elf's going to have to stick around his main base while the Orc is going to have to play a tag with his Night Elf army. What is this Blade Master doing? What is he doing? He has a potion of greater healing, but he cannot afford to take on this Night Elf army head on. No! Oh god, now Orc is forced to fight a whole full-on war against Night Elf army here. Is he gonna let the Blade Master die? Yep, he's not gonna even use that potion of greater healing. He knows there's no point doing that. So Wine Raiders are gonna be left behind. One of the Night Elf heroes has to come back and defend this. Is it gonna be the Demon Hunter? Really? Okay, Night Elf is gonna face against a hero-less Walk army. Blade Master is gonna be back. Let's see if the Blade Master is gonna turn the tide. Because Night Elf, oh good god, is he gonna mass Asian Awards and uproot him? Yeah, that's one of the ways he can counter this strategy, is to uproot all your Asian Awards. Why Asian Awards, you ask? I'm not gonna argue with you that Asian Awards are cheaper and takes just as long to build. Don't go after the Blade Master, don't fall for that trick. There we go. He's there! There we go. Wait a minute. How did he get away? I thought the Demon Hunter was ensnared. How the hell did he get away? Anyway, two Tree of Lives? What? What is going on here? Someone tell me what's going on in this game. Wow. Alright, so the Night Elf's going to do what the Orc did to him. He's going to go after the burrows since he lost all his moonwalls. And the Orc is going to try to push the front. Night Elf is going to try to buy time for his Asian Wars to go up. Oh, back to my point. Why do you build Asian Wars instead of Asian Winds? The reason is, one, they do more damage, by the way. I don't know if you guys know. Asian Winds do... Asian Wars do more damage, and they have more HP. Look at that. 1,000 versus 900. And they... oh, crap. The Orc is getting completely effed. Oh, man. This is hard. Really, really hard to swallow. Anyway, another Ish Tree of Life. So the Night Elf is gonna spend all the money. Oh, sorry, all the money on Tree of Life, because he can. Ancient Wars is way too vulnerable to A Tree of Life has like almost double the HP, and they're pretty beefy to build. So we're going to see a base race here. A Tree of Life is going to root into the gold mine that has 2,300 gold left. Still worth it. And looks like the Blade Master is going to go after the Ocean Lord. The Ocean Lord is going to go down for sure. Remember, Orc has pillage. Remember that. That's going to get him I thought he had a pillage. No, he didn't. He didn't have pillage. Why do you mass raiders and don't have pillage if you're going to go for base trade? Wow, he didn't have pillage. I had no idea. So apparently that gold increments wasn't by 10. It was because he had an expansion. So all these towers, I think all but one, all but this one is going to get saved. All but this burrow is going to get not canceled. Let's see what's going to go on here. So the orc is going to force a base trade here. And looks like the Night Elf is going to... Oh, God. Oh, chase the peons away. If you kill all these peons, the orc... there's absolutely nothing orc can do. Chase the peons, no! Chase the peons. Okay, kill that burrow. You're going to kill the Great Hall. That can be another strategy. But neither player has enough... Oh god, I think you just send your hero back here to die, really. Yeah, what are you doing? One by one here to die. Shadow Hunter is going to lead the retreat after all three heroes are back. So now the Night Elf army is going to retreat from attacking this Great Hall. And now Orc just boss, he's just saved his expansion by doing a base trade. Now he can come back and work. By the way, if you have a peon, this is one trick that I don't think the orc player knows. If you have a main, like a mining base near a gold mine, and if you right click a peon to it, the Night Elf were not able to entangle the gold mine. Doesn't matter where the peon is. So he can use one of the peons at his expansion, right click those gold mine, and when the Night Elf try to entangle it, it'll say the gold mine belongs to another player, you cannot do it. That's one trick you can stop that entangled gold mine from going up, at least for a while, until the peon dies. But now I don't know what the orc raider is going to do. Where are his raiders? He has about, let's see, about four raiders. Where are they? TP, where is he going? He's going to go, okay, over here. That's two raiders. He had a bunch of peons. I forgot how many peons he had. And another tree of life is going to go up. That's what I thought. What are you smoking? And now let's see, the reason the orc is building so many towers is not that he need all of them. It's because if you build 10, you're going to end up cancel 7, so you're going to have 3 in total. That's why he's building so many at a time. He dumped all his lumber on peons and burrows. Look at this. I'm sorry, towers and burrows. Oh god, nothing but an exciting game of Warcraft can get you out of sickness. Anyway, so the Night Elf got to rebuild an altar. I forgot he didn't rebuild an altar after that base raid. And now he's going to have to build an altar to revive his tinker here. Now where is he going? Where's that Demon Hunter going? I don't know. Anyway, so it looks like, yeah, see, the orc canceled the tower because he know that all the towers he built are not going to be canceled, so that's why he canceled the tower there. And this main was taken down by the orc player. One of the Shadow Hunters was doing things over here that the raiders were actually killing that tree of life. I'm sorry I missed it. But orc just needed to make sure Night Elf's not mining at this point. Remember, Orc still has money in the main. That can be proven useful later on if he can tower off the main. And I really don't know if it's worth it. Only 2.2k gold left. If you tower this place a couple times and then start mining, I don't think Night Elf's gonna bother taking it down. So it's a plain little strategy game here. You don't have to have enough towers to be able to defend a full-on assault. You just need enough towers to make your opponent hesitate attacking you. That's all you need. That's pretty... Oh, there are 4 units around. What are you doing? 4 units around. You could have done it. Oh, God. It looks like the orc is going to be a pussy here. Not want to get his Shadow Hunter mana burn. No. Oh, never mind. Too late. The entire Night Elf army is back. You could have cut off that... who would have forced that user pushing lesser vulnerability right there on the Demon Hunter? One lucky critical strike! Oh my god! The last critical strike was 207, that's why I said one lucky critical strike, the Demon Hunter was going to have to be killed. Because you gotta remember there's Raiders and Shadow Hunter around hitting. That was Demon Hunter! No! Oh god! Demon Hunter! Thoughts are gonna do some blocking and cycloning! Demon Hunter, no! Oh, nice block! Oh, but two Raiders showed up! And Demon Hunter is gonna go down. No! Oh my god! Demon Hunter used more wells, and now the Orc is screwed. The Orc's Blade Master is completely screwed. Cyclone the Blade Master, what is Night Elf doing? Okay, at least he can kill 3 units right here. Get that Shadow Hunter first. Cyclone, there we go. And wait till the raiders come down. There's one. Cyclone the raider. Cyclone the raider. Don't let him get away. Oh, God. No, Staff of Teleportation. I don't think so, buddy. And looks like the Shadowhunter is going to have to use the TP here. Or at least I think. Because you're mining on two gold mines. Why wouldn't you use the TP? Anyway, Night Elf is going to reestablish his mining base over here as soon as he tangles his gold mine. And the Shadowhunter is going to... Oh, get away! No, Cyclone, no! There we go. Press move. There we go. Now he's surrounded. Entangled gold mine's going up. I really don't know who's going to win the game because Night Elf has an army advantage. I really don't think Orc is going to match this army advantage anytime soon. Looks like two burrows are going to go up. Just as good as towers. And that's about it. The raiders are going to go for another raid. Grubby would have built... last game I casted Grubby. Casted about Grubby was about the last... What was that? Anyway, he built two shops, so if... I think one of my subscribers said if he got pushed either way, lose that shop, he can have the secondary shop to fall back on. And the shops are cheap as hell. So, looks like the Intelligent Gold Mine is going to get repaired. Oh, it's under construction! That's why he cannot be repaired. But still, once it finishes, he can repair this. Nope, the Whispers are going to hop in. What? Repair this. Yeah, there we go. In the meantime, what is Shadowhunter doing all the way there? I think a misclick. It looks like Nautilus is going to force another base trade. This time, I really don't think Orc wants to save this base. Because what? Is there 1,700 gold left? Really? You really don't want to do that. Looks like Nautilus is going to abandon all the Moonwells. So Nautilus is going to have to rebuild all the Moonwells one more time. Alright, this time I have the expansion. Alright, let's... I really don't think when Lawlet started this game, he really didn't think he's going to make like 20 Moonwells. Because he'd be losing them over and over. I'm gonna go into Orc vs. Night Elf game. I'm gonna build 20 Moonwells total in this game. Yeah, that's my strategy right there. And looks like Raider. Oh god, I should have canceled that Raider, buddy. And now guess what? Orc has got to rebuild his production buildings. He should have rebuilt a Beastery and a spare lounge before he lost Tier 2 tech. Oh, now what'd he do? Oh man, he really should have done that. Should have rebuilt the tier 2 buildings before he lost the tier 2 tech. And now the raiders are going to try to force another base raid. You don't absolutely need to have production buildings on this map because there are two merc camps on this map. Also, same principle applies to Twisted Metals. That map has, what, four labs and two merc camps? Holy crap. People can just buy mercs this entire time. Mercs are not cost effective at all compared to regular units, by the way. That's why nobody builds mass mercs in the game. Maybe people do in like 4 on 4 or something, but in 1 on 1 you cannot afford a mass mercs. I don't care how big your economy is because they're so fragile and they're just not combat effective. Oh, the secondary beastery, I didn't even see that. So, Orc is going to make one more raider out of his beastery, trying to sneak this one out. Let's see if the Night Elf is going to scout this. Night Elf can see... Oh, he's not going to see it if Raider do this correctly. Oh, never mind. No, I don't think the Raider can end anywhere to go. But now he's going to TP, because his base is getting raided. Now he's going to force a counter TP from the Orc. And that's how you save your buildings, apparently. And then Demon Hunter is the only hero that gets left behind, and I think this is bait. I don't think Orc wants to do hiding here because this is where Night Elf army is going to come into. But it looks like Demon Hunter knows what's coming and he's going to staff out of there. Orc didn't lose any critical production buildings, only lost one beastery, and he can still mix things out of these two buildings here. And here we go. Is he going to creep or is he going to buy mercs? I really don't know what he's doing here. In the meantime, we're going to see Moonwells are going to go up again for the third time in this game. 5 Moonwells again. This is the 15th Moonwell this Night Elf player has ever built. And Night Elf's gonna creep, I don't know why. Maybe he's gonna... Is he... No? All these heroes... I was gonna say, if one of the heroes has like one shred of experience away from the next level, you can creep. Spend some time to get the next level, get the next ability, but... I think Tinker is the only one who can benefit from creeping this, and these two heroes cannot be around. Especially this Demon Hunter, there's absolutely no reason for him to be around. So this, they are they gonna really actually creep at 30-minute mark? Are these players gonna creep at this smallest map on the Blizzard ladder is not gonna, was not crept out at 30-minute mark in the pro game. That's amazing to me. Holy crap! What is going on here? 2 clock stop plus 9 and 2 clock stop plus 6. Doubles the damage on the Blademaster. Oh god, that's when I have a headache, especially when I play undead. I saw Blademaster was like plus 30 or more. I was like, oh crap, what do I do? Yep, this is the one of those things. Another cost attack plus 6. Who picked it up? Oh, Shadowhunter picked it up. Oh man, switch your items around. Give the boost to the Shadowhunter or something, so the Shadowhunter can give you this one, another claws attack plus 6. Oh god, it has more claws than a cat. Cat only has 4, this set of claws. So now, with the Night Obstacle Force head-on engagement, that's when Orc is going to go for a base raid. Where is he going? Go for base raid, go now! While buying time by repairing your tower and loading your burrows, load of burrows! Oh god, there we go. And now, oh god, let's see if the Nidalee has any strategy in mind besides building additional wards to defend against the base raid. Blademaster isn't revealing himself, so Nidalee knows what exactly Orc is up to. Is he gonna go defend, or is he gonna come into the base raid? Is he gonna go snipe some burrows and then TP, or what? Because he absolutely has to TP, there's no way he can match the damage output from the raiders against buildings. Raiders are gonna go focus on moon wells. Yep, and no, actually one of them is gonna peel off to go after the tree of eternity. And it's, oh no way, that was gonna come into this base trade because he's building a secondary base right here. But he needs to bring all the lumber wisp out of there. He's repairing it. He's gonna mass TP, cancel the why is that wisp didn't, oh the wisp is right close to the lumber. Spell Worker got killed by Goblin Worker, Clockwork, and that's a bad sign when you... It's a misfortune, really. Tree Returns got to uproot and eat a tree to save some money. Why is he saving money? I don't think either player has made any units for a while now. I don't think either player has gone over 50 food the entire time. Oh god! The Blade Monster can block this rooting of the Tree of Eternity and can possibly kill it! Oh man, all hands on deck, repair! Detonate the wisps! Oh god, nice save. Oh man. I don't know if it's, it would be worth it. A level 5 Blademaster trading? No, it wouldn't be. But I don't, even if he wants to commit to that trade, I don't think he will. It'll happen. Oh god. Oh man. Having sore throat and screaming into a mic is really not a good combination. And by the way, I'm drinking, so that's, yeah. Insert your usual not drink while sick comment here. Anyway. What is going on here? The Shadowhunter is going to try to creep himself. He needs to sell one of the items, because this is going to be a sweet, pretty good item drop here. Even if you don't want it, you can just turn around and sell it. You need to sell more something here. I think Shadowhunter might want to sell this Call of Haste. Kind of useless when you... on a Shadowhunter. 15% of 1 is still 15%. Just kidding. The Hawks are heading his way. That's why he backed off, because he does not want to get creep-jacked. So the Demon Hunter can go after the Wizard if he wants to by himself. But he's going to go for this Bay Trade again before the towers are completed. Mass repair the tower! Where are you going? Oh god, and Orc is going to go for another base raid at the 4 o'clock. I need to see the minimap. I don't have to look at the minimap to know what's going on. And the Nidalee should too. He doesn't need to have to see the Orc units around his base to know what's going to happen. That's why he stopped 2 heroes back to buy time. I really don't think Nidalee is going to make any units from this point on. Is he going to... Okay, the Nidalee army is coming back, so yeah, the Orc is sticking around just to make sure the Nidalee army is coming back. And leaving the, oh god, a level 2 pocket factory with a level 2 engineering upgrade. So annoying on the Orc gold line. Oh my god, especially when you don't have burrows to take that out. What is the Orc going to do? He has plenty of money. Not going to, is he mining? Oh, he is mining at the main. Peons can just gang up on this Quail Beast if they want to. Nope. Okay, now I was gonna do a little goose chase here, trying to go after these raiders. The one raider, every one raider you can kill is one victory. Especially spirit walkers, that's even better. Nice use of that bird form just to save the dots. Looks like, yeah, the orc is gonna TP, so the Night Elf is gonna go right after. What is he gonna try to save the wisp? Just detonate it! What's he trying to. Why are you trying to save this wisp? So you can staff teleport here later, or what? Try not to grab the tome? Grab the tome! Alright. Anyway, we're gonna see you buy more TP. Yep. Last time I remember the orc player didn't TP. He walked away when the Nautilus. Nautilus didn't TP either. So that was even trade. What is gonna happen this game? Orc cannot play. Base trade forever. He eventually he's gonna have to play a head-on game. I've seen games that two armies never really clashed. So you never know. Orc is gonna mine this map out before you're gonna do anything now. You're gonna have to, yeah, start killing these great halls or the fortresses, whatever they have. Looks like Nadov is gonna stop the Demon Hunter back and just be a Superman to defend the entire Orc army. Look at him. Such a boss. I don't think the Demon Hunter is any luck, and now he's gonna force a TP from Nadov, and Nadov did take that out. So the only place Orc can TP is his main, and Nadov could have faked the TP. Never mind, he does not. Neither the Beastmaster nor the Tinker has a staff for teleportation. I was gonna say, if he faked that TP, the orc backed off, then you're golden. And looks like the Pocket actually did timed out. Let's see how the orc is gonna do with his 420 gold. He did rebuild some burrows, had a 1.7k banked before he used on something. What did he use on? He spent like 300, 400 gold right there and then. What did he do? Did he get some item? No. I think he got a TP or something. Did kill that Tree of Life though. I don't think I think that works out for Nato's favor because he does not want to occupy gold mine and has, what, 2k gold left. Are these two going to mine out this entire map? Really, dude? No, this gold mine has pretty good amount of gold left. Master, what are you doing? Oh, doing some sniping. I really like this. When the orc is... Oh, okay, I'm sorry. Now I'm going to turn these to birds! There we go. And they're going to stick around and do a cyclone! Oh, nice turn use of bird form just to keep them away from the Playmaster damage. Meanwhile, the raiders are going to come in and snipe some moonwalls and get out. I think the Playmaster might be in trouble. Has a potion of vulnerability on him. And this hawk is doing splash damage against DOS, by the way. But the Playmaster is gonna bite the dust! Orc is gonna GG... Wait. Is he gonna Tyrant the Playmaster? He has enough money to Tyrant a level 5 hero, I know that. He's gonna get his TP the Shadow Hunter, yep. I really don't know what Orc is gonna... His plan is. Is he rebuilding his... No? Long distance mining right here. Run out of money in the back. Grab the Blademaster out of the tavern, and he's got to run for it, no! And Nightelf knows that the only place the orc army can stick around is the main, these raiders with Fairfire may give it away, but he's coming after McGork's main. I don't think Orc wants to do this. By this I mean taking on a Nightelf army head on. Okay, Nightelf is going to come over and check. Using the wisp just to see if there's a expansion going. And now Orc is cornered, and this might be it. Oh, Shadow Hunter, Blademaster, no! Blademaster has absolutely nothing to save himself. Didn't even go to the shop after the tavern. There's a chain heal just to keep the Blademaster alive. Oh, he did go into the shop for a little while. Blademaster needs to do damage. As you're surrounded, you might as well start. No. Blademaster's gonna go down the second time. There's a GG by the orc. Oh my god. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I need to drink some syrup or something. Phone's calling me. Later.